we are facing this race. And most of the vaccines, if not all of the vaccines, with a few small exceptions, are focused entirely on sort of version one of this virus, actually pre-alpha, you know, the very first virus that was first sequenced. And what that means is that today we're now projecting out getting the world vaccinated over the coming year. And that's, you know, if we have most people in the world vaccinated by the end of next year, you know, that would be a remarkable accomplishment. But we have to also be continually updating how we're thinking about this, how we're producing the vaccines. Are we going to, what happens if we have to start over? And what I mean by that is, what happens if it turns out that the Delta variant or whatever next variant is coming down the pipeline on the evolutionary train that this virus is on starts to break through immunity in the elderly people, for example? So we know that elderly people don't keep as strong an immune response in general. And so if in a place like the United States or in high-income countries in Europe, we start to see that the elderly start to have breakthrough cases of a new variant just because their immunity drive from the initial vaccine is now a year old and they're starting to wane a bit, do we then ethically start giving them a third dose of a vaccine when most of the world still remains unvaccinated? And in particular, what then happens if we start developing whole new vaccines that are targeting updated versions of this virus? Do we start giving people who have no vaccination in their arm yet, do we give them the new doses with the new sequences encoded in them? Or do we give them the old versions and give the wealthy countries the new versions to keep them updated? Now, I think that these are going to be exceptionally difficult questions that need to be asked now. I think we should absolutely be developing the plan for it now.